Good morning, all of you. Now we are doing economics chapter number one, the story of village Palampur. Now our topic is how is land distributed between the farmers of Palampur. That means in this portion we will just discuss about distribution of land in Palampur. If you will see in your NCERT book picture 1.5, you will easily see that in Palampur maximum farmers are having small size of land, and as not all the people engaged in agriculture have sufficient land for cultivation, same in Palampur also. 1/3 of the 450 families, as yesterday we have discussed about, there are 450 families. Out of that 150 families, they are landless. Most of them Dalits, and they are not having any land for cultivation. Remaining families who own land, 240 families, they are having small size of land, that is less than 2 hectares in size. Cultivation of such plots, if the size of land is small, so it does not bring sufficient income to the farmer family. Now Siddhi, you just read this case study in your NCERT yes, book. There is a case study in 1960, because that is very important. Aryan, don't eat.
Mom, shall I start?
Yeah.
In 1960, Gobind was a farmer with 2.25 hectares of largely unirrigated land. With the help of his three sons, Gobind cultivated the land. Though they did not live very comfortably, the family managed to feed itself with a little bit of extra income from one buffalo that the family possessed. Some year after Gobind's death, this land was divided among his three sons. Each one now has a plot of land that is only 0.75 hectare in size. Even with imported irrigation and modern farming method, Gobind's sons are not able to make a living from their land. They have to look for additional work during part of the year.
So what does it mean that in maximum farms, farmers are having small size of land? So they had proved with the example of a case study, that is a Gobind was having a 2.25 hectares of unirrigated land. Unirrigated land means they are not having the irrigation facility. They still dependent on monsoon, and they were barely to manage the feed itself. But after Gobind's death, land was divided among his three sons. And now each one has a plot of only 0.75 hectare in size. So after that, they have adopted the irrigation facilities also, modern farming methods also, but still they were not able to make a living from their land, which is very difficult, because the small size of land, if we will adopt the modern farming methods, but the output will not be improved to a large extent. So in this picture also, picture 1.5, that indicates that maximum farmers in Palampur are having small size of land. 150, they are not having any land. 240 families, they are having less than 2 hectares of land. And after that, if you will see, that is, there are 60 families. They are known as medium and large farmers who are having more than 2 hectares of land. And if we will say large size, that is more than 10 hectares or more, that is very few farmers are having large farms. So what does it prove? That in Palampur, maximum farmers are having a small size of land as in India. Next is who will provide, that is the next factor of production. What are factors of production? We have discussed factors of production in the beginning. What are the factors of production? Yes. What are the factors of production? Beta, how much time will you take to? देखो मैम आ गई इन चार्ज मैम तो नाउ एवरीबडी ओपन अ कैमरास एंड गिव द रिस्पांस ओके
मैम लैंड कैपिटल
मैम लैंड कैपिटल एंड लेबर
यस इफ वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट फैक्टर्स ऑफ प्रोडक्शन दैट मींस लैंड व्हिच वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड एंड नाउ व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द लेबर So now second factor of production is labor. Labor, there are two types of labor, skilled labors and unskilled labor. Now in Palampur reference, we will discuss about this thing that who will provide the labor. If you see that when we have discussed about distribution of land, so maximum farmers were having small size of land. So how will they get the labor? Who will provide the labor to that farmers who are having less than 2 hectares of land? Can anyone? Who will provide the labor?
Ma'am, factory.
Pardon?
Ma'am, I am saying, ma'am, that factories can provide them labor.
Yes. If you are talking about the small size of land, those who are having, automatically they will provide labor to themselves, because when small farmers along with their families, they cultivate their own fields, that means they provide the labor required for farming themselves, because that is not having sufficient income and all. And after that, when we are talking about medium and large farmers, what will they do?
And they will hire small laborers and small land laborers.
Yes. Small farmers.
Yes, medium and large farmers hire farm laborers to work on their farm fields. Up, we are talking about farm laborers. Farm laborers come either from landless families or families. Those who are having the small size of land, farm laborers. Previously, we have discussed about farm laborers. They are not having any land, so instead of getting money, sometimes they are getting crop also. Instead, they are paid wages by the farmers for whom they work. Now wages can be in different forms, whether in cash or crop. Sometimes laborers get wages also, meals also. Now we are talking about wages. Wages vary from region to region also, from crop to crop also. That depends upon the working of the labor. There is also a wide variation in the employment condition also. A farm laborers can be daily wage earner or for the particular activities also. So when we are talking about all these things, automatically wages will also be different. Okay, now we are having a case studies. Yes, Divyanshi, can you read that case study about Dala?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, read it.
Dala is a landless farm laborer who works on daily wages in Palampur. This means he must regularly look for work. The minimum wages for a farm laborer set by the government in rupees 300 per day, March 2017, but Dala gets only rupees 160. There is a heavy competition for work among the farm laborers in Palampur. So people agree to work for lower wages. Dala complains about his situation to Ram Kali, who is another farm laborer. Both Dala and Ram Kali are among the poorest people in the village.
Now, can you tell me why are farm laborers like Dala and Ram Kali poor? Yes, anyone?
Ma'am, because they are forced to do work in low wages.
No, first thing is they are not having any land. They are labor classes and they are not getting the work on a regular basis also. This is also one of the major reasons. They are not getting their work on a regular basis. Along with that, there is a huge competition because wages are set by government around kitna hai? That is around 300, but it is in your NCERT book. Now the wages have changed because government always announce the wages which vary, jo vary karte hain. Okay, so now wages are different. But being the poor farmers, they are getting less wages. And due to this, they are poor. Okay? So this is the